Thank you. There was a clear plan of the ECOWAS to create a safe passage or to evacuate the former president, though, so that an interim government can set in. Do you know, and this was alluded to by the American diplomat my colleagues have referred to already, do you know whether the former president's visit to the Freeport was a part of this plan, which led to his subsequent death?
I would think so. I would think so. Because I think President Lassana Conte had sent to Do, asking him to leave with as many of his men as possible. And Conte's invitation to Do was that I've got a massive country, sparsely populated. You can bring as many people as possible. Come to my country. You are a young man. There's always time to go back. Don't risk your life. I heard that, of course, people were approached and they were making arrangements for Doe to leave. But then, of course, Quainoo, General Quainoo, had not visited Doe. And so, my information, and I rely on Sally Thompson and a few other people, my information was that Doe had gone down to the port to engage Quainoo and to say to Quainoo, you've come to my country, you're an African man. When you get into the village, you must find the chief. What happened between the executive mansion and the Freeport, we can only guess. There are rumors that somebody called somebody and said, the man is at the port, and elements from the INPFL went down to the port, and there was this altercation, insults. General Quainoo panicked because he was convinced that there are crazy people all over. There are crazy people all over. I mean, he saw these people doped, I mean, and drunk with heavy machine gun, and I think he panicked. And he went whether to call for reinforcement or whatever, but he left Doe and his people in the room. Elements of the INPFL came, shot off his people, arrested him, and all we know is what we saw on the tape. What happened between the mansion and the Freeport, we can only guess. I read it and know. But I'm convinced that probably, yes, I think Doe wanted to leave. I believe he wanted to leave.
Do you think ECOWAS regretted that incident?
Oh, very much so, very much so. As a matter of fact, it was an insult to the dignity of the armed forces of these West African countries. And the first casualty of that was General Quainoo, who was taken from the position of field commander and replaced by General Joshua Dongoyaro. Because it was said that in the presence on the base of the ecomog forces, this man was taken, brutalized, tortured, and killed. No army will accept that. It was based on that General Quainoo was brought in. I mean, General Dongoyaro. Those of you who were here on this, you knew what Dongoyaro did. You know what he did. Because they were not going to have a repetition of that. Soldiers are different. It's possible that had it been Dongoyaro, things would have been different. But it was not Dongoyaro.